Welcome to the final part of American Wasteland. This time we're doing all the creator mode stuff. We're doing the creator part, we're going to be going through all the crap with that one. And we're going to check out a bit of multiplayer afterwards and then the credits. So, yeah, creator park. It's just fuck twos, creator park. It's just the same creator park. There's a little bit of a difference. The themes, I guess there's some new themes. I'm pretty sure these are the ones in fuck two, though, so it's not that big of a deal. But, yeah, here are the themes. We'll show them all off. Pretty much all the pieces, however, are just fucking fuck two, though. And by the way, I'm going to just do my best to expand all of this all the way through so that you can really, really see how much there is. This is as big as you can make your park. Of course, now I have barely any room. But yeah, this is as big as you can make your park, and as you can see, we can now really, really check out how far we can go with, looking at the background and such. I'm gonna do this for all of them. But, yeah, the pieces here, they are all just, they're all just gonna be fuck two pieces. Like, I think there might be a small, like, few pieces around here and there that are, oh, by the way, we can really be on the very edge of the boat here with the carrier. But, yeah, like, I'm pretty sure there's, like, a small few additional pieces that American Wasteland added. But this is the most literally copy and paste job of a fucking park this is. Also, Neversoft logo on there. The USS Neversoft THPS 2015, I believe that said. I'm surprised it said 2015, but hey, there you go. Well, 2005, I could barely even see what it was saying there. But yeah, this is legitimately just all these maps. You know, we've seen this one before multiple times, I'm pretty sure. We've seen the race car one before, I believe. We've seen all of these, I believe, beforehand. At least we're getting a closer look, I guess. But, yeah, this is just the same creator park from Bug 2. They didn't really add anything. They didn't expand on it. They didn't make it any better. And in fact, they kind of made it worse, considering they removed the creator goal stuff. And not only that, there's less pre-made parks here. This is not a joke. Compared to Fuck 1 and 2, this has the least amount of pre-made parks out of these three games. Hell, out of Pro Skater 4 even, this has less pre-made parks. And Pro Skater 3, I believe, and 2, I'm pretty sure this has less parks than any of the Tony Hawk games you've gone through already. I could be wrong. I probably am wrong. But from what I've seen, there's fuck all here with this one. I'll go through it anyway just to get it out of the way. But yeah, we're not going to get much out of this. It's just going to be a lot of the shit you've seen before. And that's it. Hell, the collector's edition didn't really add anything. Like, the collector's edition, you'd think, would add more to this. You know, give more content for us. Because it did. They gave us, like, little additional extras. They gave us two more levels for classic mode and shit. They have to fucking add more to this, right? No. No. This is all you get. This is what you got in the normal version of the game. This is what you get in this version of the game. It's just this. So, yeah, I mean, also, nice. You can kind of tell that this was not well made. You can tell by the fact that this is a very, very glitchy version of basically Fuck 2's creator park. You can see out of the bounds, essentially. in one of these maps, in this map in particular. It's just, they put the fuck to create a park in this game, and then they didn't make sure it worked completely fine. So you can see that it's really broken. It's just, it's so shit. It's so shit. I hate how shit it is. I legitimately hate how fucking shit it is. Oh, God. So, yeah. Do I really have to add anything with this? Do I have to, like, say anything more about this that I already have from Fug 2 and such? I'm legitimately upset at this game. Legitimately rather upset at how poor this fucking park creator is. And also the fact that they've removed shit. They made less effort with all of this, the additional stuff, because they just cared so, so fucking much about a god-awful story mode. That classic mode, that creator park, all the fun stuff, the multiplayer even. I'm pretty sure the multiplayer isn't very good either. They all went just downhill with everything else. They cared too much about a story mode that they couldn't even fucking finish. You already know that story mode was rushed to hell. They couldn't finish the fucking thing. But they gave a shit so fucking much about it that there was no fucking way that they were going to really put any effort into anything else. And quite frankly, I'm disgusted by that. I'm actually upset about that, because this could have been fine. This could have been cool. Instead, all we got is just a pile of garbage. And I do mean that. I do honestly mean that, in that American Wasteland is not a good Tony Hawk game. Sure, it added all of these elements from the previous games and such, and, you know, really gave us all sorts of freedom of things, but it didn't really improve the game. The story mode was abhorrent and unfun and just fucking hateful to such a degree to where I hated playing through it. I hated playing as my own character. I hated a majority of the characters. And it did not feel rewarding going through story mode, going through all the missions in that. It felt like I was just, I felt miserable going through that, essentially. And then you get into classic mode and you're thinking this is going to be a fun romp. And then it's not. It's just there. And they're all very samey. And you'd think that for these classics, these fucking golden age levels that they added in, even though half of it is just Fuck to Your Remix, but still, for some pretty good levels, you would think that they would give more of a shit with it. But they didn't. They fucking didn't. So you ended up with this half-assed classic mode after an abhorrent fucking story mode. And you're thinking, well, I'll go play multiplayer. I'll go have some fun with the creator part like I did back in Fug 2 and such. And you realize they removed a lot of shit that made this stuff more fun back in Fug 2. And the multiplayer is just Fug 2's multiplayer. And this creator park is just Fug 2's creator park. Except, you know, they removed shit. It's a lesser Fug 2 creator park. And there was no reason for that. There was no reason to even do this. They should have not touched a fucking thing at that point. They should have just kept everything the way it was from Fug 2 here. And sure, American Wasteland story mode and classic mode sucked, but you still have an enjoyable, fun fucking, you know, creator park and creator goals and all. You still have all the good shit. This is what it was supposed to be, right? This is supposed to be a compilation of everything of Fuck 1, 2 in this game. Like, it was a compilation of the best. But no, they got rid of shit that was good. And they brought in shit that nobody fucking cared about. Like vert wall plants. They should have gotten rid of that instead of adding two rail and all that crap. You know? They put too much effort in things that didn't matter. And to be fair, this is around the time when there was no competition. Where nobody was trying to kick Neversoft's ass and Activision's ass of this. Activision were the kings. Skate didn't come in yet. But this was clearly a point where people were getting tired of this game. Where people were getting tired of Tony Hawk. And who can fucking blame them when this is what the next game was going to be? Who can blame people for just not wanting to continue really supporting the series if this is the next big game? So it's of no wonder that the next game would basically be nothing like this and the previous. It would be a completely new engine, it'd be more of a realism sort of game while still being arcadey. It would be very different to every other Tony Hawk game. And not a lot of people were going to be happy about that. But hey, it was still something new. But it did lost a lot of what made this series so beloved for so long. Also, look how many huts I can put in this bitch. Look how many fucking houses I can put in this. I could have the entire map be houses. Water takes up more than fucking huts. Really? Really now? Okay, I don't get that, but whatever. Also, I can have it up to 8 players. And, you know, I can nuke the place. And of course, the premates come in. And which is how many premates they are. That's it. You thought there was going to be more because of the arrow thing there? No. The list was fucking with you. The list was lying. There is nothing more but just this. And a lot of this is just from... For fuck two. Except without the goals. There's gaps, sure, but... You know, no one gives a shit about these gaps. Also, it bugs out... When you go into name gap and you fuck off from that, it just bugs out. See? So, I don't know why they didn't give a shit here anymore. All I can hope for is that when we get to the next one, which is, what, Project 8? Hopefully things get better. You know, hopefully when they did go into a different sort of era, you know, different sort of engine and all, that things really started hyping the fuck up. Because in what I saw, Project 8 is interesting. It's not terrible. It's interesting. And then Proving Ground would come in, and that would be very drab environments, but it would have... Honestly, the best of the gameplay. To an extent. But for the most part, Project 8 and Proving Ground, from what I saw, are fine. They're you know, interesting and could be fun to go through. The one issue I have, though, for myself, is the fact that I never really got to play those. Because this game was where I stopped playing any Tony Hawk game. I got American Wasteland, and I was kind of like, eh, about it. And then I see Project 8, and I'm like, I don't want this. I don't want to play this. I liked Pro Skater 4 and 3 and 1 and 2 and fucking Fuck 1 and 2. And, you know, American Wasteland, I liked it as well, even though nowadays I don't really. But, yeah, when it came right down to fucking seeing Project Date, I was just like, no, I don't want this. So I quit Tony Hawk from there. And the only reason I'm even going back into this, playing the newer games, doing all this shit again, well, when it came to how it started, I originally just wanted to, you know, do the original games, and then fucking HD came and was a pile of shit. I did a whole Let's Play on that, even took me, like, a long time to actually finish it. And, you know, after that, suddenly you guys really came in and really loved seeing me do the Tony Hawk games, to where the reason why I'm still doing this is because of you. Oh, by the way, here's that panda suit. You're wondering what it looks like since I bought it for like a lot of money back in career mode? Here's the panda suit. It's like a punk panda. It's kinda neat. But, yeah, also the board goes for his stomach, but besides that, it's pretty neat. It's a pretty cool little, you know, costume. It's its own character, essentially. So, yeah, for the most part, you guys are the reason why I'm still doing this shit. You're the reason why I'm still playing through these games, and why I've been caring so much about the extreme sports games. Why I've cared about the fucking Tony Hawk series, why I've been playing all sorts of the other games, and really a lot of the shitty ones, and the obscure ones. And really, you're the reason why this channel is as big as it is now, because of these. So, yeah, we've reached the point where back then, this is where I quit. And if I wasn't as big as I am now, if I didn't give that much of a shit anymore, this would have been where I quit once again. But, No, we're still going to keep going. And we're going to keep going until the very end. By the way, we got extras here. We got concept art. I don't think the concept art ever showed up in the original game. So this is like one of the extras that the special edition gives you. And I'm giving you all of it. It's cool to see the art. Jimbo Phillips, even though he's a really wacky fucking, you know, character creator and such, I fucking enjoy his art. And I think it did add some quality to this game. Because I feel like his art style really fit the aesthetic of just goofiness and punk that this needed. And it's fun. It's really fun. So thank you, Phillips. Thank you for giving us an enjoyable fucking thing. And I'm guessing Jimbo, the character, is based on a character from him, essentially. Also, there is, like, all this crap here, which I'm not gonna show. Actually, I think it's all on YouTube, but, yeah, I'll probably just show it from the alt channel afterwards. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and show off the multiplayer real quickly. You can only choose some easy and normal of this one, but whatever. I'll fight Tony Hawk to the death, I guess. And, yeah, I can choose any place I want. I'm gonna go ahead and choose Hollywood for this one, because easy. And, yeah, multiplayer is just Fuck 2's multiplayer. As you can see, there's a split mode thing, there's a change area thing, and, yeah, horizontal sucks, go to vertical. And if you start the game, you can choose whatever, and they're all just the shit we've seen before, you know, score, challenge, card, mumbo, slap, pot of gold, king of hill, scavenger hunt. Very much the same shit. I think pot of gold might be different. And yeah, firefight, and horse. So, yeah, a lot of this is just shit you've already seen. I'll go through all of them, just so you get an idea on what's up. But, yeah, for the most part, this is just the same shit. It's just meh. It's just very much meh. So, yeah. I'll skim through it all. What can I say about this game at the very least? Because when we go to the credits, I'm going to shut my mouth. It's just not a good Tony Hawk game to me. I'm sorry. I kinda enjoyed it back then as a kid. I was just completely dumb about the story mode and such. I did not give a fuck about the story mode. And I was just kinda, you know, dumb about what was really going on and such. About how this game was really treating me and all. So, for the most part, as a kid, I was just stupid. And even then, as a kid, I found this to be meh. I found this to be, you know, not terrible, but I would have rather played Pro Skater 4 again. I would have played Fug 2 again over this. And I did. I played Fug 2 and Pro Skater 4 and all way more than I did of American Wasteland. American Wasteland was just... It was there in my collection. I still have it on my Xbox and everything, but it was a game that I didn't really give that much of a shit about. And I really still don't. So, yeah. Honestly, Oh, by the way, 100 million points. Yeah. Also, you can tag some shit, but... yeah, 100 million points. Nice. For the most part, I didn't enjoy this game. And I wish I did. I wish I could still enjoy American Wasteland to this day. But there's too much wrong with this. There is too much that's bad about American Wasteland at its very core. That Fug 2, Fug 1, all the other games before it, we're better than this. And this didn't really even add that much either. Like, you don't really give a shit about these areas, do you? You don't give a shit about Hollywood and such. These are not that memorable areas. Hell, the ruins, the only level that was new when it was in classic mode, it wasn't even that great of a level. You didn't give a shit about that one either. When it came to all these areas, outside of shit that was already from Fug 2 Remix, outside of the oil rig that already existed in the Xbox version of Pro Skater 3, you know, you didn't really give much of a shit about this. Like, maybe... Fuck, I'm trying to think of any area that you might have given a shit about. Maybe the ranch you might have given a shit about. Maybe you found the ranch idea to be really interesting and cool, and you found the ranch to be cool. That's fine. Maybe... Mayhaps, you even found, you know, fuck, maybe you found Hollywood to be enjoyable, maybe Beverly Hills, I doubt that. I don't know, maybe you fucking found, maybe East LA to be kinda cool. I'm fucking poking at straws here with that, but... You get the point, right? A lot of this was kind of experimental, but at the same time, it was not very good. And it was just not very fun, either. And the worst part is that while you're trying to have fun, you're realizing that this game has more cutscenes than it does have gameplay. You realize that the cutscenes and the story are just... abhorrently mean and shit and stupid. Oh, by the way, there you go, got the gold. And you're realizing that your character, your own character that you have been making for all these games, maybe, a character that you enjoy, a character that you give a shit about even, he's just a fucking asshole in this game. He's not like the character you played as in Fug 1 and 2. He's a completely different character here. And he is just an unlikable piece of shit. And the game does not do any kind of favors on redeeming him. I don't fucking feel like, when it came to this shit, that I felt, you know, redeemed in the fact that, yeah, my character was being a piece of shit, but hey, at least he fucking, you know, learned his lesson and got better. You know, got his friends back, got the ranch back. He proved himself as being more than just this fuckhead, you know? He proved himself to be a better person overall. You know, they could have done a better job at fucking doing that. They never did. They never even fucking tried. And they kind of just rushed the entire thing and just gave you the win. And I don't deserve the fucking win. I don't fucking deserve whatever bullshit you gave me. So yeah, I'm sorry, but I can't fucking enjoy this. I wish I could. I fucking wish I could enjoy this. But as it stands, I can't. I can't enjoy this because the story mode is so in your face with its bullshit that there's nothing fun about it. There's nothing about it that makes me want to keep playing it. And that's really the gist of it. That by the end of the fucking day, the majority of this you've already experienced in the other games, and the other games were a much better experience than what this game would end up giving you. And that's just fucking sad, okay? That's just fucking sad. So yeah, this, for being the last this engine, this kind of Tony Hawk game would ever get, really, until, you know, the fucking HD and 5 and then 1 plus 2 came in and such. You know, the re-envisioning of this engine, essentially. Until that happened, this was the end of this kind of Tony Hawk game, and we would end up getting what Project AIDS and Proving Ground and such would end up being, and then Ride and Shred and all of that. We'd be getting all sorts of different kinds of games. Also, slaps do not do shit for you. But yeah, it was just, I'm upset this is how it ended. I'm upset this is how this series really ended for this. And quite frankly, it deserved better. It deserved much better than this. So yeah, this was American Wasteland, and, you know, I thought this would be fine. I thought I wouldn't have this much of a negative fucking opinion and such on it, but fuck, man. Having to go through all these games again, and, you know, going for different versions of the games, and really experiencing a lot of the stuff that even back then I never knew about, it's made me realize how fucking bad this game is. And how we didn't need this. For the most part, and I mean it for the most part, I don't consider this one of the worst Tony Hawk games ever. I also don't consider this the downfall. However, I don't consider this to be very high up there. And there's much better Tony Hawk games out there than this. So yeah, that's gonna be it for my Let's Play of American Wasteland. Until I do the GBA game and such, you know, that's gonna be a thing coming up. But, yeah, for now, I'm gonna play the credits out. Thank you for watching, thank you for enduring all of this nightmare bullshit with me. And, I will see you all next time for when I do the GBA game of American Wasteland, which is the last of the GBA Tony Hawk games. So, We're going to see how the GBA stuff ends. Spoilers, it won't end well. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.
This is a little something I call the stale fish. Grab from the, with the back hand around your back foot, and I can't even explain a stale fish.
Depends. I need some more lines. I need someone to hit me in the face if I'm going to do something.
Ow!
Oh, I live here. I've been skating here my whole life, and I forgot what I was. I forgot the rest. Oh, I just noticed there's a video camera in the corner filming my face.
Beam it and show me what you can. You think you're for? Can't even read.
Are you still with me? Are you there?